If you are making mobile games in Godot, version 4.5 quietly added some updates you really don't want to miss. So, Godot 4.5 just dropped. And yeah, by the time you are watching this, you have probably already seen the flashy features. Stencil buffer, screen reader support, script color picker, all that cool stuff. But as a mobile developer, I noticed a few updates that most people are completely sleeping on. And honestly, the fact that Godot was lacking one of these features almost made me switch engines entirely. If 4.5 hadn't fixed it, I probably would have been forced to move on. Have a look at this warning from Google Play Console. It basically says that your app must support 16KB memory page size by November 1st, or else I won't be able to update my game. Well, it's Google, always finding fresh ways to keep developers busy. And guess what? Godot 4.4 uses native libraries that don't support 16KB memory page size. That means if 4.5 had not fixed it, I literally wouldn't be able to release updates for my games. But thankfully, Godot 4.5 supports it out of the box. The second big one is Target SDK level. Godot 4.4 uses Target SDK level 34, and because of that, Play Console straight up rejected my upload. I had a game ready to go, but Play Store said, "Nope, first export your game with SDK level 35. But lucky me. On the same day, Godot 4.5 dropped and it exports directly with SDK 35. I just migrated my project, which was super easy and everything worked perfectly. Now, here's the real surprise. Something that's not even mentioned on the official release page. AAB encryption. Here's the problem. Godot supported encryption, but only if you exported APKs with expansion files. And APKs are dead. Google doesn't want them. Everything has to be AAB now. I spent a whole day once trying to make AAB encryption work just to protect my game a little. And I'll be real. This issue made me think to switch engines. Because some publishers do scrape small indie games, repackage them and sell them as their own. It's basically stealing, and a lot of indie devs end up losing credit and recognition for something they actually created. Pretty messed up, but sadly it happens a lot. But to my surprise, Godot 4.5 now fully supports encryption with AAB exports. I tried it and it just works. Finally, some peace of mind when exporting for Android. So yeah, this update is not just about shiny editor features. If you are a mobile developer like me, Godot 4.5 is a literal lifesaver. Now, I am curious. What's your favorite feature in Godot 4.5? Let me know in the comments and I'll see you in the next one.